wouldn't worry nearly as much about the atom bomb if it were to kill you right out.
It didn't take long before Fluffykins had gone from sweet little Muggy to pathological man-eating killer!
Uh-oh, it looks like somebody left the vice president on ornery.
Jungle Bunny Hank Shit for Brains here for RFTV, where everything you do is an extreme sport! They're all animals! We're not talking about filthy welfare sponging, doobie smoking long hairs that hug trees here! No siree, folks! This is the story of Mad Dog Fluffykins, who ran away from home, fell in with the wrong crowd, started snorting kitty litter, and turning tricks. It didn't take long before Fluffykins had gone from sweet little Muggy to pathological man-eating killer! Teflon's gonna attempt to catch Fluffykins. He thinks it's gonna be a walk in the park. What he doesn't know about is Fluffykins' insecure boyfriend, Warren the Feral Hog! Remember, folks, feral cats, feral pigs, feral frogs, even feral ferrets! They're dangerous! They travel in pairs. Oh, what the... Oh. And cut! Whew! I'm glad that's over.
Well, as I was saying, I wouldn't worry nearly as much about the atom bomb if it were to kill you right out. What scares me is that awful gas that deforms you.
Yeah. That would be bad.
Yeah.
Dancing. sunshine from above, dancing animals in love, in the cool of the dove, dancing animals in love,
laughing
and singing and playing, dancing animals in love.
Well, Junior, why don't you go tell your mother to go f*** herself?
What seems to be the trouble, soldier? You look a little bit worried.
Well, I am, Chaplain. Just a little bit.
Actually, there's no need to be worried, as the Army has taken all of the necessary precautions to see that we're perfectly safe here.
Sir, have you ever been out of one of these shops before?
Yes, I've had the opportunity to see a number of the atomic tests. I feel that as a chaplain, it is my responsibility to be with my men.
What's it like, Chaplain?
First of all, one sees a very, very bright light, followed by a shock wave, and then you hear the sound of the blast, and then it seems as though there is a minor earthquake. And then you look up and you see the fireball as it ascends up into the heaven. It's a wonderful sight to behold.
Abraham Lincoln is deserving of glory, but when he starts drinking, it's a whole different story.
The great emancipator becomes an irritator.
He's a rabid Irish hater.
And a public masturbator.
Abraham Lincoln, hard-drinking Lincoln, stinking drunk Lincoln.
Flash me.
Time to emancipate that last six-pack.
Hold on there, Stretch. That's a national treasure.
So's this.
Holy mother.
Mr. Lincoln, how can I become a better politician?
Get some speech therapy, Porky. Oh!
General, the giant drunken Lincoln is destroying and peeing on everything in sight. How can we stop him?
With a giant John Wilkes Booth.
Holy crap. This seems to be nothing but a string of movie parodies.
It's Christmas. God bless us, everyone.
You can call him Dick, you just can't call him a Dick. Understand?
Chicks, clothing and
that is how Teeny Tiny Tom of Dim Dilly Dale showed the blissful bouncing bunnies how tax incentives on capital gains help the modern post-recession economy by stimulating growth. The end. Well, you have any questions, kids?
My dad says that you had secret meetings with oil companies to change environmental policies. Is that true?
Oh, I don't know what that has to do with teeny tiny Tom, but no, I didn't. Any other questions?
Oh. Did the administration ever find any weapons of mass destruction?
Any other questions? Questions about the story?
My mom says your former company, Halliburton, got the contracts for rebuilding Iraqi oil lines without having to bid against any other companies.
Junior, why don't you go tell your mother to go f*** herself?
Uh-oh, it looks like somebody left the vice president on ornery.
Captain Capitalism, where did you come from? Oh, gosh. What's going on? It happened again, didn't it? Oh, Lord. Lord, Lord, Lord.
There, Mr. Vice President. It's okay. I'll handle this. Hey, kids! Well, the Vice President just said something that you should never, ever repeat. He said the F word, also known as the F-bomb. It's an adult word. It's what we call an obscenity or a vulgar word. Only grown-ups like Mommy and Daddy are allowed to use words like that, and only when they're really angry or when they get cut off in traffic.
What makes a word a curse word?
Well, that's a good question, son. You see, a long time ago, special committees like the MPAA picked 10 or so special words to be obscenities. Then they used these words as a way to rate the movies and TV shows we watch.
How do we know which words are the dirty words?
Oh, right. Well, you can't say sh**, f**k, dick, ass, cock, p**, cunt, twat, tit, or goddamn. But it isn't just the word, it's the context. Many of these words have homonyms. For instance, you can say cock when you're talking about roosters, as in cockfighting. You can say pussy when you're talking about cats. You can say bitch when you're talking about a female dog. And you can say ass when you're talking about donkeys. However, if the donkey and the rooster got in a fight over the dog, you couldn't say the ass called the cock a p**, so the cock kicked the ass in the ass and his p**, bit him really hard on his cock. That would be vulgar. Also, Vice President Cheney's name is Dick. You can call him Dick, you just can't call him a Dick. Understand? Furthermore, all of the dirty words have synonyms that aren't vulgar. It's okay to say poop instead of shit, butt instead of ass, and f***ing instead of pussy. F***ing. I guess that one's not okay. But you get the point. So you see, children, once you turn 18, you can say these words as much as you like. Until then, I don't ever want to hear you saying shit, fuck, dick, ass, cock, pussy, cunt, twat, tit, or goddamn. Got it, kids?
Yay!
Ha, 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 great. Now, you want to see something really cool?
Yeah!
Woo!